This video is going to be about ChatGPT and OpenAI. I'm going to be showing you an amazing way to create very quick and very easy blog posts using this tool. Go on Google and type in AIPRM Chrome extension. Download this Chrome extension and then go to ChatGPT. This tool adds these prompts for SEOs. But what I actually want to show you is how these prompts work and why they're going to change SEO forever. Let's just take this one here, keyword strategy. So click on keyword strategy. I typed in the other day, best sweaters, and I pressed enter. What I learned from this tool blew my mind. Firstly, it can create tables, which I didn't know before. You can see this is completely insane. But what's even more interesting is the way that these prompts work. And prompts are going to be the number one skill when it comes to AI in the future. You mark my words, prompts. What are prompts? Prompts are the way that we talk to AI. They are basically instructions for the AI, okay? So the idea is the better the prompt, the better the output, which means there's a huge difference between saying, write me some good keywords for best sweaters like I did before, or using these prompts. The thing is, it seems like you can't see what the prompt is here, but I actually worked out exactly how to see the prompt here. So I'm gonna press continue here so it just stops writing. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let this save. I'm gonna click off it, and then I'm gonna click on this content plan. This is the prompt, guys. Look how insane this prompt is. Let's break this prompt down so that we can see how we can use it and how we can abuse it. And I'm going to show you how we can get ChatGPT to write a very concise and very good article. So I want you to act as a market research expert that speaks and writes fluent English. Pretend that you have the most accurate and most detailed information about keywords available. Pretend that you are able to develop a full SEO content plan in English. I will give you the target keyword, best sweaters. From this keyword, create a markdown. Markdown is HTML without the coding, basically. Table with a keyword list for an SEO content strategy plan on the topic best sweaters. Cluster the keywords according to the top 10 supercategories and name the supercategory in the first column called keyword cluster. This here, so best sweaters, that's the cluster. Best cashmere sweaters, okay? Best sweaters for men, best sweaters for women, best wool sweaters, best sweater brands, how to care for wool sweaters, etc., etc. Add in another column with 7 subcategories for each keyword cluster or specific long tail keywords for each of the clusters. List in another column the human search intent for the keyword. Commercial, these are all gonna be buyer keywords, okay? This is informational, but the rest of them are buyer keywords. Then in another column, write a simple but very click enticing title to use for a blog post about that keyword. Then in another column, write an attractive meta description. Okay. This already is a service that you can sell to people for hundreds of dollars. Just this table alone, you can then back it up with the keyword research using Google AdWords, keyword planner, whatever it might be. But I guarantee you that this content created here is already good enough to sell, okay? And let me show you an example of this. So you may or may not know that I am a professional SEO for a company. I recently created this entire website for the company that I am working for. The website I made is twomen.it or twomenitalia. And if I scroll down and if I go on this article here, okay, I wrote this article in 3 minutes using ChatGPT. I'm going to show you exactly how I did it. But is this article on Google? I actually don't know because I haven't checked since I uploaded this article, but we are about to find out. Of course it's on Google. That's amazing news. That doesn't mean it's getting any traffic yet, but it does mean that the article has been indexed on Google, which means it's now available for getting traffic. Everything you see here, this is all AI, okay? I've written everything with either ChatGPT or Jasper, depending on how far back you go. but most of it is ChatGPT. So what I actually worked out was that the most useful thing we can learn for ChatGPT is actually the prompt. A lot of people are worried that their job is going to be taken, okay? And I understand that you think that your job is going to be taken, but I have two points to make against that. Number one is if your job is at risk from AI, you are not good enough at your job, okay? So you're not good enough. What does that mean? That means I am a professional content writer, I'm a professional SEO. I have no fear that my job will be taken by AI because I am good enough at my job that my boss will need me at least for the next 5 years until they create some kind of super AI robot that does literally everything to do with SEO. But my second argument against that is you have to adapt. You have to adapt. What does that mean? That means that you can become the expert in AI, okay? Prompts is going to be a huge niche. Being able to create prompts that give people the content they want is a crucial skill in the AI revolution. And it is a revolution, guys. I'll tell you that right now. So what I actually did was I took this prompt and I turned it into something that would give me exactly what I was looking for, okay? And let me show you how I did that. So what I did was, instead of saying, first of all, whoever made this wrote details incorrectly, which really annoys me for some reason. Pretend that you are able to develop a full blog post. I'm going to put the word listicle as well. I will give you the target keyword, or the title will be best cashmere sweater brands, okay? This is from the tool. The tool gave me the idea for this blog post. Remember, I just showed you. It's right here. Best cashmere sweater brands. From this title, creates a markdown. No. Okay, we don't want that. We don't want this either. So we can get rid of this as well. We can get rid of clustering. Get rid of the column. Get rid of the meta description. We can get rid of basically everything else, okay? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to say the H2 titles of the article will be, and then you'd say like introduction, and then you would say something like, why are cashmere sweaters so popular? And then I'm just going to quickly go back here. Okay, no, it's already brands. So I'm focusing on brands. The reason that I'm focusing on brands, you don't have to focus on brands. You can focus just on, you know, colors of cashmere sweater. It depends what you sell, okay? But we sell brands, and our brands have cashmere sweaters, okay? So that's why I'm focusing on brands. So all I'm doing is I'm going on clothing, I'm going on sweaters, okay? And actually, I can't do this because we don't have the filter. So what I'm doing instead is I'm going to type in cashmere sweater on the search, and then I'm going to click on brands. And you can see I've already written this article. It's right here. So I know that Brunello Cucinelli, Cesare Attolini, Fieroni, Gran Sasso, Chiton, and Marco Pescarolo, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 brands, okay? So the title would be the best 6 cashmere sweater brands in the world, let's say. The H2 titles of the article will be introduction, why are cashmere sweaters so popular? And then all I did was I just took these here and I put them into the AI. You will have to delete some things if you're using Shopify, obviously. So I'm just going to quickly do this. Okay, so that's the base of the article. And then I'm going to put another comma and put conclusion like this. What I'm going to then do is I'm just going to stick this straight into ChatGPT. And if it works like it did the other day, it's going to give me a full blog post in probably less than 2 minutes. I'm going to pause the video. We'll see how this goes. It's going a little bit slow today just because I think so many people are using this goddamn tool right now. But I'll leave this tool. You can see now it's 10 o'clock. We'll see what it is when it's finished. Okay, so the time is now 22:02. But what I'm going to say right off the bat is some of this information is not correct. Okay. I'm pretty sure Antonio Gran Sasso does not exist, for example. Maybe he does, but I'm pretty sure he doesn't. Yeah, you can see that this particular one is not true. The reason for that is Gran Sasso is not a famous brand. Cesare Attolini is an incredibly famous brand. This information is correct. Brunello Cucinelli, incredibly famous brand. This information is correct. Kiton, probably the most famous classic menswear brand ever. This information is 100% correct. 1960s by Ciro Paoni. That's correct. This Marco Pescarolo is also correct. It was founded by a guy called Marco Pescarolo. But the Gran Sasso one, I'm pretty sure, is not correct. And Gran Sasso, I don't think, was founded by someone called Antonio Gran Sasso. So what I'm going to say, first of all, is you need to know the niche. And also, you can see why this is why AI will not fully take over from people, at least yet, okay? But what it does give me is an article, okay, of, let's see how many words. A tip here is do Control, Shift, and V when you paste so that it doesn't do any weird formatting. Let's do word count, 511 words, okay? Interestingly enough, As I said before, I wrote this exact article already, and let's see if it's on Google. I'm pretty sure it's on Google, but I actually can't remember if this one is on Google. Let's have a look. Should be. I'm pretty sure this is on Google. And again, that doesn't mean it's getting traffic, but it has been on Google for a few days. So let's do a live test and see if it's got any impressions yet. So what I'm going to do is, this is Google Search Console, if you don't know what I'm doing. You click on New and then click on Page and then do Control V of the article. 6 impressions, that's not even bad. Honestly, that's not even bad. I think this article is like, I think I wrote it yesterday. I wrote it yesterday, January the 10th, 2 days ago. I wrote this article 2 days ago. If you know anything about SEO, the fact that it already has 6 impressions is really, really good. And if I do most recent date, you're kidding me. You're kidding me. That's actually insane. Wait. Nah. I shouldn't be giving this. I should be selling this information, honestly. I honestly should be selling this. I should not be giving this away. And this is another article I wrote by AI as well. I'm just going to release this video, guys, before I decide to never release it. This video, if you watch this from the beginning to the end, will give you the tools that you need to make an insane amount of articles very, very quickly. This works really well with these listicle articles for e-commerce stores that you are selling. You're selling the brands, you're selling the types of jeans, best 5 types of jeans, whatever it might be. Let's just do a very quick check before we go on Search Console. I'm gonna click on New, Page, URL contains best, and hit enter. 196 impressions. All of these articles that you can see were written by me, by AI in the last 2 weeks. They're already getting a crap ton of impressions, guys. Look at that. That's the end of this video. One more thing before I go. If you know anything about SEO, this website is brand new. It's brand new and it's already going very, very well. I should be selling this information. I shouldn't be giving it away, but you know, you guys know me. I like to give things away for free. Thanks for watching and peace out.